Hey, welcome to Tabletop Skirmish Games. I'm Lee, and in this video, we'll be going through how to build your Ork Commandos for Kill Team Octarius. We've got a few options of how to build our Ork Commandos for Kill Team Octarius, and there's a few books that we'll need to use before we start putting them together and a little bit of planning to do. These are much easier than the Death Corps of Krieg that come in the Kill Team Octarius box set to put together and to choose your operatives, but I still thought it'd be fun to put together a little video just to show you the variations that are included for the Ork Commandos and some ideas about how you might want to build your kill team with what you get in the box set. We'll be using this book that shows us how to assemble our miniatures, and this is the same one that shows you how to do the terrain and everything. And we'll also be using the Octarius supplement book that comes in the box set. And then this is going to tell us what operatives are available for the Ork Commandos. And then from this, we can decide which ones to build out of this book. But I definitely recommend having a really good look at the sprues, because they're so good. The detail on these is fantastic. The backpacks are amazing. And there's a lot going on with the different heads and faces and things like that. So I would have a good look through all the different weapons as well and get a feel for what you like the best. And you know, if you want to go for more of a visual kind of kill team, then have a look through that and just pick out what you like. But if you want to go and stick with the different operatives, or you've got some tactics in mind, then you definitely need to look at this book before you start putting them together. Okay, let's start with the Octarius supplement book, and I've done a separate video on this which goes through everything in the book, like a little book review to give you a good idea of what's included. So we're not going to go into too much detail now, but it's a really good book. It's got lots of detail about the Ork clans and everything you need to know. But this is where you're going to find your data cards and the information in that for which operatives you can use as well. So we want to go to page 58, and this is going to tell us what operatives we can include in our kill team. And for the commandos, well, for all the different kill teams, it's going to be different. But so for our commandos, we can have one commando knob, and he can be equipped with a slugger and big chopper, or a slugger and power claw. So that's our first choice that we've got to make. And then we can choose 9 commandos, which can be selected from the following list. So we can have a commando boy, commando grot, slasher boy, breacher boy, sniper boy, dacker boy, comms boy, burner boy, a rocket boy, and a bomb squig. So we can choose to take 9 of these into our kill team. Now, if you went for the commando boy, you are allowed to take 9 commando boys, but you can only take 1 of all of these others within your selection. So that's something to bear in mind. So this gives us the option with our box set. We've basically got 10 Ork Commandos, a bomb squig, and a commando grot. So we could make our commando knob in one of the variations, and then we could make 9 commando boys if we wanted. Or we can make a commando knob, 2 commando boys, and then 1 each of all of these other commandos. So that's the kind of options we have. Of course, you could just also do, say, for instance, a Dacker boy, a comms boy, a burner boy, and a rocket boy, and then make 5 commando boys and 1 commando knob. So there is a little bit of variation here, a few options. Another option on top of that is to make 1 of each of the different types, but proxy them for commando boys if you wanted to. You might not be playing a kind of what you see is what you get style then with your models, but it gives you more options with your gameplay, and having all the different commando operatives available is certainly going to make it more fun. And when you do different missions, you're going to need to take certain commandos into the kill team with you. So you've got to bear that in mind too. So this is the page you want to look at, page 58, and then that's going to tell you what you can include in your kill team. I've just grabbed the core book as well, because there's one other thing to consider, and that's the fact that you're going to have a roster which you can include up to 20 operatives in. Now, you're only going to get 10 commandos plus your bomb squid, squig, and your commando grot. So you're going to get 12 in the box set. So if you want to take in 20, you're not going to have 20 models. So you can still have 20 operatives on your roster, but then you'd be using the same models for maybe 2 of them or 3 of them, that kind of thing. So just bear in mind in your planning stage that you can have up to 20 in the roster, and that might affect which ones you choose and how you work it. You might even buy another box of Kill Team Octarius or wait until they bring out the commandos and then get another set as well and include that in your planning phase. So you know, for example, if you built one of each, you could then proxy, say, a Daka boy for a regular commander boy, because you know when you get your next set, you could make all commander boys, and then that's going to give you pretty much all the options then. So that's another thing to think about. So this is on page 91 of the core book. Okay, I hope all that made sense, but now we'll move on to the instruction book that shows us how to put them together. And so again, this is from the box set. So this is going to give us all the options for our Death Corps Krieg and our commando. So here we go, the commando kill team. So you can see right away we've got the two options. We've got the commando knob there and there. So we can have either the commando knob with the slugger and big chopper, or the commando knob with slugger and power claw. So I'm going to build this one just because it looks awesome. I'm kind of just going for me, for looks really. I like the look of this one a lot more. I'll probably look at some points as well on those data cards to decide. But that one looks really cool. And this is the one that's been featured in all the kind of videos and a lot of the photos building up to it. So I really like that one. And then as we move through, you can see you've got different options of building with this one, the slasher boy, or in the same pose, you can have the commander boy. So pretty much for each operative that is kind of different from a commander boy, you can either build them as that individual operative or a commander boy. So if you did choose to do 9 commander boys and 1 commando knob, they are all going to be different. So that's really good. You're not going to get any doubles if you do it that way. And obviously, if you do all the different operatives, then they are going to be different too. So that's a really good feature of this, I think. Some great variation, and they're all going to look really different. So you're going to get a choice with your main commando knob, and then as you work through, you can get some options until you get down to number 16, where you can only build as a commando boy. And also, let's have a look on here, number 21. You can only build that as a commando boy too. So these ones are going to be only commando boys, and then all the others, you've got the option of building as either a commando boy or a special operative. Once you've built all your commandos, it gives you this on number 22, and it says times 2, and I'm a little bit confused on this because there's only one model that looks like that, but these are all the extra little parts that you can put on the models however you like. So I'm not sure what that times 2 there means, whether it refers to this other commando here, whether you want to add some extra bits on there or not. So not sure on that, but you can pretty much add these to anyone you want. You can put them on any of the fighters, so it really does, all the operatives, it doesn't matter. And then up here you see you've got the bomb squig, which is, you know, only one way to put that together, and the commando grot, again only one way to put it together. So for me, I'm keeping things really simple, and I just like the look of everything, how they've laid it out. So I'm going to build the commando knob, and then I'm going to build the different commando operatives that you can build, and those two commando boys. So I'm going to have my choice from here. I'm going to have pretty much every one of these, but I'm going to have 2 commando boys. So that's the way I'm going to go. Keep it nice and simple. Copy these pictures. It looks really great. And then when I paint them, I can also use the images in this book, which are really good. If we flick back and have a look at the section, you can see it's got some really good images. And here they are, those special operatives, the Rocket Boy, Comms Boy, Slasher Boy, Commander Boy, Daka Boy, Sniper Boy, all painted up. So this will be a great reference. And then you'll find the rest of them in the different formations and the way you can build them in here. So if you just went all Commander Boys, again, you've got a nice reference there to look at about how to paint them. So that's what I'm going to do. So now I'll go away and build them, and then I'll show you them all put together and just go over any bits that I thought were tricky or that didn't match up with the instructions, and then hopefully that'll help you out when it comes time to build your Ork Commando kill team. And here they are all put together. I'm really happy with how they turned out. Really easy, no snags at all, and I think they went together really well. The arm joints just went in just at the right point, so even lining up those different weapons with the different hands just went together with no problems whatsoever. So the ones I've built now, I've got the commander knob, and I chose to go with the slugger and power claw because I thought that looked really cool. And then I've gone with 2 commander boys and 1 each, of all the others. So I thought it'd be cool just to have a quick close-up look of each of the models. And then that's going to be it for this video. And then I'll do another video where we do a deep dive going into all the detail about their stats and everything, looking at their data cards and all the unique actions they can do. But for this video, let's just keep focusing on the models and I'll show you up close what they all look like. So first up, we've got the two Commander boys. And I think any that you make into a commando is going to look really cool. I love all these funny masks they've got. They're packed with weapons. The axes are really great. And they've got their pistols there. But it's the backpacks that I really like from this whole set. I think they're fantastic. Each one is different. This one's even got some little cups and mugs hanging off it. Different batons to bash people with. Weird kind of stabbing weapon. Maybe a harpoon gun it looks like there. And all different canisters. Some dynamite, rope. All sorts of things. This is like a little scuba diver here. So really nice. So they're the two commando boys. And so these are the ones that if you build one of all the other models, these are the two that you'd be left with. So you could choose, I think, to make different packs, but I went with the ones that were included in the instructions. Then we've got the slasher boy. And he's got all these different daggers, one in each hand, one in his teeth, one on his belt, a few canisters. And again, that awesome looking backpack. Next is the Breacher Boy. This real cool weapon. This looks awesome. Just so big. And what a great model. And then on the back, you've got a big mallet there to bash some doors down with. Some dynamite in case he needs to be a bit more explosive with it. But a really great looking model. Then we got the Sniper Boy. I like playing snipers in any skirmish game like this. So this one's fantastic. Loads of ammo, so he's not going to run out. All over the back of the backpack. More canisters, all these little pouches. These are going to be great fun to paint. I'll be doing the painting videos as well on the channel real soon. So look out for those. So that's the Sniper Boy. And now we've got the Daka Boy. And this has got a really awesome weapon. Three barrels, but it's the little beanie hat that make this guy look really cool. So that was a great touch for a commando orc. So I really like that. Got the roll mat. Huge dagger on the back. All sorts of other little things going on. There we go. So that's the Daka boy. And now we've got the comms boy. And there's so much character in these models. It's just fantastic. And there we go. Good look around. But this is a real interesting weapon that he's got here. With the coil on the front. So he's going to be able to listen out maybe to the enemy. And then pass on those commands. Nice. Then we got the Burner Boy, and we've got to have a Flamer in our Kill Team. And this is the one that you would have seen on the feature video for Kill Team when it was first released. And I love how they put an oil can on the back, even with a little pump, to pump the oil or fuel into that Flamer. And the mask is just brilliant. Even a little gauge there. Really well done, these models are. Then here's the Rocket Boy, and I can't wait to paint these. Really can't. They're going to be so fun to paint. So many details. I think the contrasts are going to work really well on them. And then I'm really looking forward to doing the deep dive videos as well. I'm really getting stuck in to the stats and their data cards. Now we're on to the smaller ones. And this is the Commando Grot. And he's got a little grappling hook launcher. He's got his scuba gear on. Even got some flippers on the back. Just brilliant. Great little model. So much character. He's running along. Going to do some sneaky damage. Really awesome. Then we have the leader, the Commando Knob. And with two choices of weapons, I had to go with this one. That claw just looks fantastic. I love his cap and the snarl on his face. Bags of character. And he's a little bit bigger than the others. Got this little radar on the back so he can keep in touch with his comms. So many details. Just fantastic. I love the scope, how chunky it is on the gun too. On the little pistol. So there we are. That's our Commando Knob. That leaves us with one more. And that's our Bomb Squig, and here he is. I think this is going to be a really popular miniature. Just covered in dynamite, coming out of his mouth, flying along as he's running towards the enemy in some kamikaze madness to do some serious damage. But a great little model. Really well done. Love it. And that's it. So that's all the models now. So a fantastic set, and I think these are going to be great fun to play on the battlefield. And if you haven't picked up yours yet and you're wondering what's included in the Kill Team Octarius box set, then check out my unboxing video where I go through everything in great detail so you can see exactly what's included and make your mind up whether or not this is something you'd like to add to your collection. I'll put some links in the description below where you can save up to 20% on the RRP for not just the Kill Team Octarius box set, but also the compendium and the additional dice you can buy as well. Those links will take you to Element Games and Wayland Games, and there'll be affiliate links, but don't cost you anything extra, and you also support the channel as well, as I get a small commission from any sales made through those links. So thanks so much for that. It's really great, and I really appreciate it. Let me know which operatives you'll be choosing for your Ork Commandos. I'd love to hear what kind of kill team you'll be putting together, and I really hope you enjoyed this video. And thanks so much for watching. Please like if you like it, subscribe for more videos like this, and don't forget to hit the notification bell to join me next time on Tabletop Skirmish Games. If you like this kind of content and would like to support the channel, then please check out my Patreon page, and thanks to everyone who's joined so far. It's really awesome. We hang out on Discord, talk about the hobby, share ideas and help each other out, and you'll get some perks there that you're not going to find anywhere else. So I'll put a link in the description, and it'll be great to see you there.